to see everybody here today to enjoy this wedding together for Walt and Shirley. And so we thank the Lord for this great occasion that we can be a part of. And we're glad to have our Pastor Cliff with us and his wife and V and other relatives and friends that are close to them. And so at this time, we can have the wedding party come forward. We are gathered here today in the sight of God and the presence of friends and loved ones to celebrate one of life's greatest moments. Marriage is a picture of Christ and His church, and they call the church the bride of Christ, and so it's a special happening. Paul said it's honorable in all and the bed undefiled, and Jesus graced marriage in Cana of Galilee with His presence and with His first miracle, turning the water to wine. We're here to give recognition to the beauty of love that is shared between Walt and Shirley as they complete as they seal their love and holy matrimony. Marriage is a contract not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, with a deep realization of the obligations and responsibilities. Marriage is a moment where hearts and souls are joined together in their walk on earth with the Lord. As I was thinking about this wedding ceremony, I was thinking about some passages in the Bible that talked about love. And one of the greatest love chapters or books in the Bible is the Song of Solomon. Solomon talking about the Shunammite girl and his love toward and back and forth and the conversation. And as I thought about this, I thought one of the verses rang out to me, and I wrote a little poem which I want to read to you. This is extra, you don't have to pay for this. Solomon said, "Many waters cannot quench love, nor can floods drown it. If a man would give for love all the wealth of his house, it would be utterly despised." And thinking of this, waters cannot quench true love, though the sky is black from the clouds above, nor can the deserts of time dry it out. For love is more than the words you have vowed. Love is two hearts beating together when they are joined in cold weather. Even in the summer of heat, they rejoice in that they are complete. Love is the fragrance of roses red. It is the smell of fresh baked bread. It is the beauty of lilies white, and is friendship in the darkest night. Troubles in life, we have enough. Many waters cannot quench true love. And so Solomon, think about many waters cannot quench true love. And so we think about those many, many waters. And so at this time, we want to have a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you now, and we thank you as we bow in prayer before you. We thank you for the Lord Jesus Christ that shed his blood for us. Lord, we pray your rich blessing upon Walt and Shirley as they celebrate this momentous occasion in their life. Lord, have your hand upon them. Grant them the happiness and contentment as their two lives join together. Lord, bless their family and friends and their relationships that have supported them, encouraged them, and strengthened them. And Lord, just bless this home with your love and your peace. And all of God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. The joining of two hearts as husband and wife is a commitment like no other. It offers opportunities for sharing and personal growth that no other human relation can equal. A husband and wife is each other's best friends, confidants, lovers, teachers, listeners, and critics. The bond between husband and wife deepens and enriches every fact of life. Happiness is fuller, and commitments are stronger. Marriage is also encourages new experiences, finds new ways of showing their love for one another in the ups and downs of life. Walt and Shirley, as your journey as husband and wife, I would ask you to remember to respect each other and remember what brought you to this place today. At this time, we're going to have a special number by Walt and Shirley. Repeat comes later. Okay. Shirley, do you take Walt to be your lawfully wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love, honor, cherish in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Walt, do you take Shirley to be your lawfully wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, to love and honor and cherish in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, for as long as you both shall live? Can we have the rings presented at this time? Just a word before we place the rings. The ring is an unbroken circle. It represents unending love. As often as either of you look on these rings, you may be reminded of the love that you have promised to each other. There's no end to it. And They're made of gold or silver or precious metals, and so is that love that brings you together. Shirley, would you place the ring on Walt's finger and say, and repeat after me. You can keep holding his hand. Repeat after me. Walt, I give you this ring.
Walt, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
That I am choosing.
That I am choosing.
To share my life's journey with you.
To share my life's journey with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With a pledge to love you.
With a pledge to love you.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Then Walt, would you place the finger, the ring on her finger? And repeat after me. Shirley, I give you this ring.
Shirley, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And that I am choosing.
I'm choosing.
To share my life with you.
To share my life with you.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
With a pledge to love you.
With a pledge to love you.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Today, tomorrow, and always.
Just a word to the couple. Shirley and Walt, we want to wish you much love and happiness as you begin your journey together. Remember, keep the thoughts of laughter and love will be right behind it. And always keep the Lord before you, which I know that you will. Shirley and Walt, you have pledged your faith to each other in this company of your friends and relatives. And that big statement, by the power vested in me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Walt, you may kiss your beautiful bride.
Well, I get to do it.
You get to do it right in public here. Family and friends, I would like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Walter and Shirley McMillan. Walter and Shirley request your presence for reception in the fellowship hall as soon as we are dismissed. Do we have dismissal music? Okay, we are dismissed. God bless you.